Today, I'm headed to the Muddy River to find a fish that's lingered on the edge of extinction for decades, the Moapa Dace.
Hey, guys. Hey, Lee. How are you?
Good, John.
Nice seeing you.
Dave.
Hey, Dave. So is there ever a bad day in the Moapa Valley?
No, never.
It's beautiful, right?
Right.
What are you doing? What's going on here?
We're going to set some traps out so we can look at some Moapa Dace. Those fish occur in these springs right here on this hillside and nowhere else on Earth.
I know there's been a lot of concern about this fish since way back when. Why?
They were listed as endangered in the 70s, and then there have been decades of conservation. And now we're finally starting to see the benefits of all that. The fish is coming back from an all-time low over the last 6 years and is at about a 20-year high now.
Over the years, the Moapa Dace's home has suffered from fire, habitat destruction, and the introduction of non-native fish.
Tell me about this display.
Yeah, this is one of the neatest things in Warm Springs. We actually built viewing windows in one of the springs.
And this is the stream in real time, right? This isn't a tank.
This is a wild ecosystem that we have a window to look in at.
And this water is so clear. Is it as clean as it is clear?
Yeah, it's coming right out of the earth. It's Pleistocene rainfall off the mountains, you know, hundreds of miles away.
But what else do we have to see?
Well, we have some traps set because we like to periodically look at the fish. And then we have a snorkeler downstream, so he's actually in the water with his face mask, counting the fish as he moves upstream.
Oh, let's go. I got to see this.
Yeah. All right.
The Moapa Dace Count takes place here twice a year. Many agencies and organizations work together to implement conservation and recovery efforts.
How many of these fish are in here, do you think?
Well, in the whole system, we have over 2,000 now. As recently as 08, we had less than 500.
Well, that's the right direction.
Yeah, no, we're doing well right now.
At what number do you finally sit back and in your recliner and go, we did it, we feel all right?
The recovery plan states that 6,000 fish in a stable with multiple life stages and most of the springs. We don't have to have all of the springs, we have to have most of the springs in a healthy condition. And if we get to that state, it'll be a very deliberate effort. But at that point, we can delist the fish.
Today, there are approximately 2,400 Moapa Dace in these waters. Let's meet Kevin Guadalupe, who's counting them.
Hey, Kevin. Good seeing you, man.
Hi.
What's going on here?
So we caught 9 spring fish, and we caught 2 Moapa Dace in our traps. And sometimes what we'll do is we'll measure them, and that lets us know how old they are and what condition they're in. This is about 50 millimeters long, and so it's about a year old, maybe a year and a half. And as you can see right here, this is Moapa coarsea, and that's Latin for leathery skin. So you can see it has really leathery skin, and it has a very distinct black tail or spot on the back of the tail.
Oh, yeah, I see it. How long do these guys live?
About 3 to 5 years. Fish in Warm Springs, they have very short lifespans because their metabolism is sped up. They have to eat a lot, and they swim a lot, and so they have very short lives.
Now, in terms of trouble for them, predators, things that they got to worry about, what are they?
It's mostly non-natives over the time. Since the 60s, there were legal introductions of aquarium fish that happened, and those usually compete for food with these fish, and sometimes they'll eat them as well. Right. So we try to get those fish out and move them and keep the good fish in.
So you're going to put these guys back in just a minute?
I will.
Water management plays a big role in the conservation of these Moapa Dace. This is Dave Sizdek, a biologist with the Southern Nevada Water Authority.
And this is one of your favorite spots?
We call this the Lower Petterson Stream. This is an artificial stream. Back by the entrance, the stream used to flow the other way through those palm trees, and the water was spreading out, and it was shallow and cooling off, and it didn't make it back into the river. And it had originally been diverted up there for irrigation. So we put the water back towards the original channels, and this is where the Moapa Dace like to hang out.
So you literally dug a ditch and diverted this water in here?
Yes.
How's it working?
We constructed it in 2008, and we now have more Moapa Dace living in this stream than we did when we constructed it. We have usually 300 to 500 Moapa Dace in this section of stream.
How does that feel to you personally? Because it worked.
it's a great success. You know, our primary focus is to conserve the Moapa Dace and to restore the ecosystem for the dace. But so there's 20 other species. There's some aquatic species that live in the streams. We do a lot of habitat management for birds. This is a great birding spot.
There's something about seeing the desert come alive and species like the Moapa Dace getting a second chance. Dave has one last stop for me.
You know, this spring is a great story. When we diverted the stream, the water level dropped up there, but it never dropped here. And we realized we had a good-sized spring here.
It's unbelievable. Are there fish in here now?
Yeah, this is an important spot for the Moapa Dace. We usually have a handful in here, and this is where they come up from further downstream to breed.
You know, what you're doing out here, it's so inspiring. And I want to say thanks on behalf
Thank
of everybody.
Thank you for coming out.
All the work that you've done. Before I let you go, what are some of the plans that you have continuing on out here?
We want this to be a destination for seeing wildlife, especially birds, and we're going to manage it for the wildlife, and we want people to come out and enjoy it.
I'm wishing you luck. It's really been great and inspiring hanging out with you today.
Thank you very much. Come out and see us.